Welcome back to Breakfast. While international discussions on climate change continue in Glasgow at COP26, the very real and sobering impacts were heard and seen by one very powerful speech recorded in Tuvalu. Tuvalu's total land area is less than 26 square kilometres. Already two of its eight islands are on the verge of going under, swallowed by rising sea levels and coastal erosion. It's home to about 12,000 people, but scientists have long predicted that within decades from now, the islands could become uninhabitable, meaning an entire nation will be forced to migrate. Here's a snippet of Tuvalu Foreign Minister Simon Kofe's speech to the world leaders, which has since gone viral.
In Tuvalu, we are living the realities of climate change, sea level rise, as you stand watching me today at COP26. We cannot wait for speeches when the sea is rising around us all the time. Climate mobility must come to the forefront. We must take bold, alternative action today to secure tomorrow. Fatailasi, Tuvalu Modetua.
Minister Simon Kofe joins us now. Talofa Simon, wonderful to have you with us this morning.
Talofa Idris, it's a pleasure to be here.
Simon, we just spoke to our climate change minister, James Shaw, who was on earlier, and he has a direct message to you. Meanwhile, Tuvalu can't afford to wait for the rest of the world to get their act together. Your nation is disappearing as we speak. This is what our climate change minister has said.
I would say he has every right to be as angry as he is about the lack of progress. I actually met with his minister representing Tuvalu here this afternoon, and they are, you know, deeply concerned about the lack of urgency and the lack of scale and ambition that's required.
Nations around the world have until Friday to agree to deals, but tell us what is happening in your nation every day right now.
Well, it's very pleasing to hear reports coming back from COP that they're making some progress, and they've released their first draft. And our team there are very optimistic that we will come back with very strong concrete outcomes for COP. So we're looking forward to that. But the reality is here, as you've seen in the video, rising sea levels, you're seeing a lot of erosion along the coast. We're seeing extreme weather patterns, changes in weather patterns. So these are the challenges that we're facing in Tuvalu, and we were hoping that the video could convey that message to the people to see that this is what we live with on a day-to-day basis.
Scientists have predicted that Tuvalu will be uninhabitable or underwater, your islands, within the next 50 to 100 years. I understand locals feel like that actually could be sooner, but how does that feel, the reality of that?
Well, it's it's shocking for people to know that they may not be a Tuvalu in 50 or 100 years. But the government is taking strategic steps to protect ourselves, and obviously there's technology that's available to be able to build our islands up and to reclaim land, which is what we are doing at the moment. But yeah, the people have a very close tie, spiritual ties to the land as well. So you can imagine the psychological impacts of that on the people.
Yeah, I mean, tell us about that. I mean, this is the reality of losing your home, your nation, your land within one or two generations, and having to move, relocate.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, that's a possible reality for us in Tuvalu, and we're looking at all different avenues to be able to protect ourselves and working on a worst case scenario. How are we going to live and coordinate government services remotely or from a different location? So although we are advocating for bigger countries to make stronger commitments against climate change, we are being proactive on the national level to prepare for the worst case.
So in the case that the entire population needs to relocate within the next few decades, what countries have offered you a home?
Publicly, we've received an offer from Fiji. I think this was a couple of years ago. but we haven't really looked further to other countries for that. But again, we're also mindful that a relocation as a solution, as a primary solution, is also a quick fix and can in fact defeat the advocacy that we are, that we're promoting at the moment. So relocation is a last resort for us. And the primary, intent is to ensure that countries do take bigger cuts with their emissions.
And tell us about the maritime boundaries that your country is seeking to protect legally. So in the case that Tuvalu does go under, we can still look at the map of the ocean and say that was and still is Tuvalu.
Mm-hmm. That's correct. And we are looking at legal avenues to be able to secure that. And we understand that under international law, maintaining your status as a state on the international plane essentially comes down to recognition. And if you're able to get the global community to recognize those principles, then that can become part of international law or customary international law. So we're doing that by, our foreign policy, the Sikulangi. We're making it a condition that if you want to establish ties with Tuvalu, diplomatic relations, that you recognize those principles, that we are, the permanency of our statehood and also our claims to our maritime zones.
In your speech, you spoke about the future of Tuvalu being a digital nation. Explain that.
Right, so we've tied digital these digital initiatives to the worst case scenario where we have to relocate. So the idea is to basically protect everything from our cultural practices, our cultural knowledge, and also our government services to operate remotely. So the idea is that you lose your land, but you still exist in the cyber world, and you can operate from anywhere in the world. So I believe there's technology now to be able to do those things, and we're taking very positive steps in doing that now.
Wow, it's unimaginable, Minister Simon Kofe, to think about the future of your digital nation, but also incredible that you guys are seeking those avenues to protect your sovereignty and culture. We do wish you all the best. Mm. We thank you for your powerful speech and your powerful video that you made. Tuvalu Foreign Minister Simon Kofe, whawhitai lasi.
Whawhitai lasi, it's a pleasure.